Well, the election could now be called at any minute, with the Prime Minister clearing a major hurdle. He has won a legal battle in court over the preselection of several New South Wales Liberal candidates. He took his pre-election campaign to Sydney petrol stations today to try to pump up support.
The Prime Minister was back campaigning in Sydney.
We're here today in a place I used to fill up my car pretty regularly, actually, because Jenny used to live up the hill here.
With a mountain to climb, according to the latest polls, Scott Morrison was spruiking a fall in petrol prices. Oh,
thank you.
Courtesy of the fuel excise cut in last week's budget.
We've seen 20 to 30 cent falls already all around the country.
A temporary tax cut to provide
cost of living relief flow through to Australian families, to individuals, as they're going off to work, getting around the city.
Scott Morrison's budget sales pitch came as the shadow treasurer fronted the National Press Club to lament
a budget riddled with rorts and chock full of wasteful spending.
The opposition leader addressed the National Farmers Federation today, pledging $500 million towards new agricultural ventures.
This will encourage investment in value-adding and growing exports.
All part of Labor's pitch for votes in the regions.
It will help diversify the sector and it will open up new possibilities for trade. And it will help create more jobs in the region.
Meanwhile, late this afternoon, there was good news for the Prime Minister. A court challenge that would have rendered a series of important preselections across his home state invalid was dismissed.
How good is Australia?
Paving the way for the election to be called in the coming days.
Good on you. Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.